You will notice there's a button or function called fix. And I love this. When it's lit, it is in ready to be used. So you'll notice it is always lit after you've used the selective thread cutter. So watch what's going to happen. When I step on the foot control, go ahead and it will lower the presser foot and take about 5 stitches, and then it starts to sew. So if I wanted those same locking stitches at the end of my fabric all in the same place, I can go ahead and push fix while I'm sewing. And there's those stitches once again, about 4 stitches at the end. And I can use the selective thread cutter and cut it off. Now, watch what happens when I use the fix button when I am not sewing. So I'm gonna just stop right here. And if I touch the fix button, like I wanted to do it, it's gonna go ahead and do 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it's gonna keep going. So one thing I always recommend is if you want it at the end of your seam that you're making, go ahead and plan that you sew right up to where you want it to be and push fix. As soon as you push fix, we'll do the locking places right there. My foot is still on the foot control and it's already stopped. Then use the selective thread cutter. Now, here's just another note, and we'll talk about it when we talk about the selective thread cutter. If you're starting out and you're sewing, you want that fix at the end, instead of touching fix, then selective thread cutter, touch the selective thread cutter while you're sewing. It will do the fix and the cut all at once. Can you see it kind of blinking? That indicates that it's going to go ahead and do the whole sequence all at once. So you can get that fix to be on demand anywhere you want. So ready, set, touch the selective thread cutter, fix and cut all at once. And that is so nice. Kind of gets you used to doing it. And that little knot definitely makes a nice secure finish for each of your beginning and ends. If you don't want the little locking stitch at the beginning, you can go into the set menu and turn that off.